Hurry up. Wait a second, this is not made of cheese.
I never said it was made of cheese.
Yes, you did.
No, I never. Like the video and subscribe.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman.
I'm a game developer.
And today we are going to create a game without programming. Let me show you the demo. It is. Yes, this looks like your regular platformer game. And you're thinking this is nothing special. Except for this time we have perfect pixel collision. Now notice that our character is not getting stuck. You can walk up to the edges. And it's perfect pixel collision. So let's open the working file, which you can find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is also a link down below where you can download a free copy of it. There's also a link to the paid version, which allows you to create commercial games. Let's go over this asset. Going to double click on the little green guy here. Here's the walking animation. Jumping animation is only one frame. Those are active objects, and don't let the name fool you. They're actually just pictures. They can be animated. There's a background. Yeah, this background can be set to obstacle. The background, there's a gradient. You can see that this is also a backdrop, meaning a picture. If you want the different images, you can always import different images. For example, if I want to import this candy bar, then this becomes a candy bar, which I'm going to leave there. I think that looks cool there. I'm going to leave here. Are other backgrounds. Now, if you run this frame, you notice that nothing happened. Okay, so let's build this game. All right, so let's get started. Going to lock the background and let's insert a
platform object.
This is my platform object. Set the jump strength to 600, just because we can. Place that anywhere you like. Now here we have this blue object, which is just an active object, or I should say a blue picture. Let's go to the event editor, and at the start of the frame, going to set the object to be the blue box, or rectangle. Now this background is set to be an obstacle. Okay, let's make a new condition. The blue box collides with the background. Then we go to collision. Then under collisions, we select object overlaps and obstacle. We actually have to enter it here too.
Test for obstacle overlap.
Try it out. You can see that that works fine, but if I press the key, nothing happens. Make a new condition. And under keyboard, repeat while key is pressed. Right key. Go to user input. User is holding the right key. Try it out. You can see that I can move my blue box. Going to copy this condition and switch it to left, and going to, and under user input, user is holding the left key. Right out. You can see that we can move left and right. Now if the user presses a space bar, we can make our character jump. Under user input, select jump. Try it out. You can see that now we can jump. Now we're gonna attach this little green guy to the blue box. Okay. Let's create an always under special conditions. Always select position. We click the blue box right out. And now you can see that the little guy is attached to the blue box. Select the blue box properties. Invisible at start right out. There you go. And now it looks like we're moving the green guy back to the editor. Under line 3, change the direction of the green guy right. And under line 4, we change the direction of the green guy to left right out. You can see that that works not too bad. But we have a walking animation we can use. Copy these two lines, 3 and 4.
Paste them under 7.
Delete all this. And we are going to change the animation to walking.
Both.
And to press right. You can see that it works not too bad. But if I let go of the keys, he continues to play the walking animation. Line 9. Upon pressing a key, right.
Do an insert.
Bumpers left, and now we negate this, make them negative, meaning if the user is not pressing these two keys and the green guy is standing on the ground, then we change the animation sequence to stop. Try it out. When I let go of the keys, he returns to his normal animation. Now when you jump, it looks kind of funny. Let's give him a jumping animation. Let's read the state of the character. Object is not standing on the ground. Negated. Object is not standing on the ground. Which case he will be jumping. So we change the animation sequence to jumping. Try it out. You can see that now our character changes animations. If I press spacebar a bunch of times, You can see that our character continues to jump regardless if he's not standing on the ground, and this is not Flappy Bird. So to fix that, we are going to insert a counter. It's our counter. Let's create a new condition. If the object is standing on the ground, let's copy this. Or if it's not, standing on the ground, then we switch this to 1. And when the object is standing on the ground, we set it to 0. Let's go to the part where we press spacebar. This is only going to work if the counter is set to 0. Try it out. Every time the character is in the air, the counter turns to 1, which disables double jump. But now we want to be able to stand on this platform. Back to the event editor. I'm going to copy line 2. And we're going to change it to something else.
Replace collide with background. Object collision with another object.
And it's going to be collision with this pink object. It's cake, I think. Right out. You can see that now I can stand on these muffins, cakes, whatever they are. And I cannot reach that one there. Let's double click on the platform object. And let's set the gravity to 24. Straight out. Maybe he needs to jump a little higher. We'll click on that again. And let's set the jumping strength to try this out. And 700 seems to work. This level is a lot bigger than this. Let's fix the scrolling. Let's go to line 7.
There's the storyboard controller. Center window position in frame.
And it's gonna be relative to the blue box. So just click the blue box. Straight out. And now you notice that we have perfect pixel collision. To right click on the play area and let's insert a new active object. Let's place it here. Can probably change the picture. Let's try this yellow lollipop. When we touch this, we get to go to next level. Now, if you click on the storyboard editor, you can see that there are more levels you can go to.
If you want to make more levels, you simply make more levels.
You can make as many as you like.
Let's go to the editor.
And, if the green guy collides with the yellow, whatever that is, under the storyboard editor, we simply send our character to next frame. Now to run the entire game, you need to click on run application. Okay. So here it is.
We have perfect pixel collision. No getting stuck.
And now when we touch that, we are going to go to next frame. Yeah, there's nothing in next frame. Obviously. Now what I like to do is sometimes I just clone this, and now I have two level 2s, 3. And I can come in here and I can change a few things. Add a few.
Change the background color.
Here's level 1. 2. And here's level 2. Now if you wanted to give this game to a friend or something, all you have to do is go to build, export application, save it as an exe. Okay, so here is the exe file, which you can give to anyone. I'm going to double click on it. And let's play it. You can upload this to Game Jolt, to anywhere really. Now there is a free version of this software you can use. Now this software also allows you to export to Flash, HTML5, Android, and iOS. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Follow me on Twitter. Like this video. I will see you in the next episode.